In today's video, Nick Bear does fitness.
All by myself.
Guys, welcome to Austin. It is Sunday morning, and we are starting off today at this establishment, Jack's Kitchen, Jack Allen's Kitchen. This is Nick said this is his favorite place, and now I know why. Fantastic breakfast buffet. So I think the plan for today is do a little cliff jumping, maybe do some lifting. So we'll figure out a topic to discuss, and we'll enjoy one more day in Austin before we head back to Tampa, and then it's on to Chicago. All right, guys, let's go. Hey guys, what's going on? I'm here in Austin, Texas, and it's been an awesome event, and we're at a powerlifting seminar at Nick Bear's gym, and I found someone that I wanted to talk to because she brings a different side of the sport, and that is a psychological side of the sport. This is Jerica Bornstein, and she's studying. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what you're studying and what you're trying to learn, and I'll explain why I think that's valuable.
Yeah. So I'm currently in the process of getting my PhD at the University of Texas at Austin. I study psychology, and broadly I say it's health psychology. So I actually study close relationships specifically, and I'm interested in health outcomes. So how our mental and, how our close relationships affect our mental health as well as our health behaviors. And so think of this as our stress levels or depression and how those things relate to our health outcomes, such as health behaviors like food and exercise. So, for instance, being in a relationship with somebody, how being in a relationship with them affects our eating habits, and so how our close others support us or kind of help or hinder our health behavior goals.
Awesome. Yeah. So, Jerica has a YouTube channel. She's going to be putting out more content. As she finishes school, she'll probably have a little more free time.
Yeah. I just finished my second year, and I have 3 more to go, so lots of more content to come.
I honestly feel like the more content you put out, the more it generates, because you start to think in a, in a manner that's creative for content creation. So we're going to have a discussion here in just a second that I'll share you some highlights from, but if you want to see the full discussion, go to Jerica's channel and subscribe, because I'm excited to see what she does over the next couple
of
years.
Thank you. I appreciate it. Awesome. I am super lucky to have Paul Revelia here with me this weekend, and we were able to talk a little bit of psychology, how he utilizes psychology with his clients.
With males, the most important thing is helping them understand how muscle building works, and that seeing the scale go up quickly does not equal muscle. Mm-hmm. It can often mean fat. And with women, without a doubt, it's the fact that they've restricted food or looked at food a certain way since a very young age. And I find that convincing them or creating an environment where they feel comfortable adding calories, focusing on putting on muscle, is the most challenging thing.
Thank you.
80% minimally processed foods, again, your micronutrients and things like that, you can fit in something like a cookie if you want to.
For sure.
If it fits your goals, if it fits your macros.
To get the most out of my physique, I'm going to use the foods that have the best macronutrient values that I get the most volume out of, mm-hmm. that I'm easily consistent with. What's going on, guys? This is Paul Revelia, and I want to do a quick video today to discuss some topics. But first, I want to thank my man Nick Bear and his brother Preston for just having us in town for this fantastic event. Mostly Nick, a little bit of Preston, maybe some Joe in there sprinkled. But the whole Bear Performance facility, it's just been an amazing experience seeing all these people come into town. I think you and I mentioned just how well everyone got along, how much fun we had, blending all these personalities. You never know what can happen, but mm-hmm. it's been an awesome experience. His gym is amazing, as you've seen from the footage. The people that you're associated with, nothing but class, and I've had nothing but an amazing time in Austin between the food, the people, the city. I'm sold. I understand why whenever someone comes here, they're like, I'm going to move to Austin.
That's how I was talking to someone on the phone, and they were like, so does everyone move to Austin now?
Yeah, I can definitely see how that happens very quickly. But let's talk about something that I think is going to help explain a little bit about how much you've done with your physique as far as putting on muscle and staying in great condition. As someone who just got out of the military, when I asked you about a topic, it was the first thing that popped in your head. Like, you clearly have this on the mind, and so I'm excited. It's something you're passionate about, so why don't you explain a little bit how you've managed to maintain?
Yeah, so like, I got out of the Army 3 weeks ago. I got off of active duty 3 weeks ago, and like every day, the question is like, how do you balance strength training, building muscle, and then a high cardio approach for someone that's either playing a sport or in the military, and like energy expenditure is high regardless. It's just part of the job or part of what you're doing. So like, this is kind of my experience with it. So ever since I started lifting weights, I've had to do some sort of high intensity cardio, that being like 5-6 mile runs or a ruck march up to 12 miles. And the energy expenditure cardio wise was very, very high, and I'm trying to maintain some sort of muscle building approach or bodybuilding and strength training. So my initial approach or technique has always been increase caloric intake.
Sure.
So energy expenditures, increase your energy intake to kind of counterbalance that. And then it's kind of finding what best fits your schedule. So like in the Army, you know, we were doing PT 5 days a week, Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 7:30. And a lot of those times were like high intensity runs or ruck marches, or you're burning calories on calories. And in the military, you have to maintain a certain runtime and a certain weight. So like with me, with strength training and bodybuilding, I can't just get as big as I want because there's height weight standards.
Sure.
And then there's run standards as well, which is like, was never my priority. My priority was always strength training and building muscle. As long as I could max my run or run as fast as possible and be like 100% on that event, I was happy. And I think naturally I'm a stronger runner as a bigger guy. A lot of people struggle with it. But one of the techniques that I found best is, you know, everyone thinks that to increase your runtime or decrease your runtime, get stronger running, you have to run miles and miles and miles.
Right.
And I read this one study that took these Marines, and they found that a lot of like VO2 max improvement workouts, like sprints, I know like you know, in bodybuilding, in strength training and losing weight, HIIT training is very popular.
Very big.
So not only for fat loss, but also increasing your VO2 max and endurance. So I use that technique to maintain my ability to, you know, run faster in my cardio instead of these long, slow duration runs.
So what kind of protocol would you use for these type of like interval training sessions, I'm assuming?
Yeah, so like I use the studies that I found that the Marines use, and I implemented it with my platoon. So like, say Monday was always a long, slower run, just for building endurance, platoon morale, stuff like that. And then when we were testing on a 2 mile run. So Wednesdays we would do short interval training. So we'd go to a track and run maybe like some 200s, some 400s, some 100s, short stuff. But it was always like 100% explosiveness, and you rest until you're 100%, you know, recovered.
Sure.
Or we do hill sprints, stuff like that. And then Fridays were our longer VO2 max workouts. So it'd be like 400, 800, 1600 meter repeats.
Wow.
Or like 30, 60s we would do.
Yeah.
So instead of like, you know, running very long distances all the time, we're doing short distances, but VO2 max focused.
Yeah.
So in turn, like, I could focus, and my whole platoon could focus our other training in the evenings on, like, strength training, bodybuilding stuff, and still balance those
out. So as a platoon, as a whole, if, so let's just say you're an outlier. How did, how was their performance impacted by this, like, style of training?
Oh, improved. I mean, like, they all love bodybuilding, powerlifting style training.
Okay.
And they hated long distance runs, like a lot of people do, unless you're, like, you love running.
Yeah.
So we found, me and my platoon sergeant found, like, experimenting with this approach is they are able to get stronger at their run.
Yeah.
And then also stronger in the gym.
And maintain.
So that they're a more balanced athlete.
Yeah.
And they can perform better and more efficient in both spectrums.
It's interesting because what's really popular right now with training is periodization protocols, like such as like non-linear, daily undulating. You are actually undulating your intensity with the runs.
Correct.
You're using different. And so that has right now been proven to be the most effective model for building muscle.
Mm-hmm.
But obviously it has applications in you know, endurance training too. So that's excellent.
Right. So I mean, overall, like, balancing those two out was very beneficial for not only me, but like seeing it beneficial for the platoon as well.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, because at the end of the day, you're their leader. So they're going to follow you. That's why I was interested, like, how did it impact them, and if it was a benefit to them, and I'm sure they value that as well. That's really cool.
Yeah.
So, all right, guys. Well, hopefully you found something interesting there. You know, Nick's doing some really cool things. I've just picked up on his journey in the last few months, and we met at the Arnold, and so I'm excited to see what you're going to do next. You know, he is freakishly strong, very talented, very well spoken. So I think you're going to do some great things in the next months, weeks, years, and there's that guy Preston helping you out too, so I know I know there's some good stuff going on around here. If you guys aren't watching Nick's channel or Preston's channel, you should be. They're really documenting the journey that they're going through building a business, getting out of the military and, you know, just taking on the world. It's been a real pleasure for me to watch, having military parents, you know, and just seeing what they went through. So I'm excited. Thank you for having me for this weekend.
I appreciate it. Thanks for
having me. Yeah, I'm looking forward to the next time we cross paths. So, all right, guys, have a good night.